This is an 18th century prison. It is actually on the site where Tyndale was imprisoned. And in those days, there would have been a castle here. That castle belonged to the Duke of Brabant.
Ah, it was, of course, Charles V, Holy Roman Emperor.
Indeed.
Most powerful man in Christendom.
It was a very damp place. The foundations of this building are actually still in the water. And that's why Tyndale asks for warmer clothes in that autumn of 1535.
In that very beautiful letter.
I wish also his permission to have a candle in the evening, for it is wearisome to sit alone in the dark. But above all, I entreat and beseech your clemency to be urgent with the procurer that he might kindly permit me to have my Hebrew Bible, Hebrew grammar, and Hebrew dictionary, that I may spend my time in that study. And in return, may you obtain your dearest wish, provided always it be consistent with the salvation of your soul. But if any other resolutions have been come to concerning me before the conclusion of the winter, I shall be patient, abiding the will of God to the glory of the grace of my Lord Jesus Christ, whose spirit, I pray, may ever direct your mind. Amen.
All was not yet lost. Tyndale still had chances. Thomas Cromwell had obtained Henry's permission to press the Emperor for Tyndale's release, and Anne Boleyn was once again pregnant. A male child would secure Henry's goodwill and his support for all things Protestant, Tyndale included.
And then in January 1536, it all went wrong, horribly wrong. Anne said that she was frightened by the fact that the king had a tournament accident. He'd fallen off his horse, but for whatever reason, she had a miscarriage. The son, and it was a son, was born dead. A great disaster for Anne, of course, for Henry, for William Tyndale. For Anne, of course, represented Tyndale's faction, the evangelical faction, the faction of the Protestant Reformation. Only 4 months after the miscarriage, Anne was dead. She pleaded with the king, but she was swept off to the Tower and in the end executed with a French sword.
It was the end for Tyndale. Cromwell's attempts to secure his release went unacknowledged by the Emperor. Tyndale was apprised that the Catholic authorities would not relinquish. He remained in Vilverda Castle until October of 1536.
He was interrogated by 3 theologians from Leuven. He was found guilty of heresy. He was handed on to the secular authorities and then led outside the castle to be executed.
Tyndale was degraded from the priesthood and released to the officers of Charles V. The church never blooded its hands. As a mercy, he was to have been strangled before the fire was lit, but the strangling was inept, and Tyndale woke as the flames rose. Witnesses spoke afterwards of his patient suffering as he burnt. Tyndale's last words were, "Lord, open the King of England's eyes." But in truth, Henry's eyes had always been open and focused on a completely different goal. Tyndale's cause was Christ's gospel. Henry's was his dynasty.
So where had we got to by the end of 1536? Well, Moore, Tyndale, dead, Anne, dead. Well, what's Henry got out of it? Well, he's got a daughter, and a daughter is at least something. He's also got a new wife in 1536, Jane Seymour, and Jane was exactly what Anne was not. She was sweet, submissive, would always do what Henry said, and also she got pregnant. And in 1537, she would have a son called Edward, like all the great kings of England. She died in the process, but that was not as important as the son, I fear. He'd got that son and heir, and that was the root of all this history.
In 1611, the King James version of the Bible was published, at 75 years after Tyndale went to the stake. And that's probably the greatest selling book in the English language in history. But in all its essentials, it's his book, because 84% of the New Testament is word for word as he wrote it. And three quarters of the Old Testament books that he lived to finish are also his. He's never had the true recognition that he deserves, because his voice actually still lives on in all those phrases that we use every day. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. The salt of the earth, let there be light. Eat, drink, and be merry. Our Father who art in heaven, my brother's keeper, the meek shall inherit the earth. The powers that be,